A tramp.
What?
That's right. You haven't even got a fat bankroll in your pocket. You probably haven't even got 25 cents.
I got 6 Cadillacs, 5 Lincoln, 4 Ford, 6 Breckers, 3 T-Birds, Mustang. Oh, I'm a lover.
Prove it by me.
My mama was. My papa too.
What?
I'm gonna tell you what.
Tell me.
I'm
trying.
Hello everyone. My name is Ahmet and my colleague's name is Mustafa. We are working as an site reliability engineer at Opsgenie product of Atlassian. As an site reliability engineer, we have to ensure that our product must available and reliable. In order to do this, we have to implement some toolings for that. Today, we want to show you one of our tools to export Kubernetes events and how to observe them, how to create an alert from them. Let's begin. Today, our agenda starts with event API. Then we talk about interesting Kubernetes events. After that, Mustafa talk with you about how to monitor and how to create an alert. And lastly, we want to show you that our tool for exporting these events, this tool will be open sourced and you can test it. Yes, Kubernetes Events API. What is an event and why they are true? This is the written in the Kubernetes source code. What is event? Event is a report of an event somewhere in the cluster. As you can see here, it is a recursive definition, but although it's a recursive definition, it is a very informative for us, so that we can know it is very important to ensure availability and reliability. You can see lots of information from events, and you can gather these events and create some dashboard from them, or you can create an alert from them so that you can understand the background of the Kubernetes. It is a little hidden from the end users, but with this kind of exportings and analyzing the data, you can understand the under the hood of the Kubernetes infrastructure. This is an example event from a pod. As you can see here, you can see the message about pulling an image. It is an informative event, and it can be seen lots of them. An event contains a message that can be understandable by human, and a reason that main enum from the source code, and it can be understandable for the codes. Types are the events. Is it normal event? Is it warning? Or you can also custom types for that, for example, an error or another things. Involved object is the main source of the event. But for example, previous example, the event source is a pod. And the source is the tool or is the logic that creates an event. And the count is the how many times this event occurred. When are the events are published? If something informational happens, for example, a pod scheduled or an image pulled or a node is healthy, then the informational events are published. These informational events may not be caused in the future as an alert or incident, but they can be used as a inside knowledge. If something can be misconfigured or wrongly used, then you can see there is a increasing of image downloading or etc. Other than you can see warning events. The warning events sometimes may be temporary. Maybe they are, for example, in here, persistent volume are not bound yet. It will be, but not yet. These are not always become an incident or alert, but they cause, in some point, they can be an alert. So we have to consider them, and we have to monitor them as well. And lastly, the errors is the most important one of the these events. They are very important, but they are least published events in the Kubernetes. So that there might be a possibility to you can miss the error events. But these events can cause incidents, outages. How can you publish custom events? We also publish our own events in our production. We can use its REST API for directly publishing events, or we can use Event Recorder for publishing events from controller, easier. If you want to see an event specifically as some resource, you can describe that resource and you can see the events for that resource. With this view, you can see what happens in that resource and you can understand how its lifecycle going. Or you can get all events in the cluster, but in this view, you can see lots of events and it is hard for any person to understand what is going on in that perspective. For scalability issues, etcd stored these events up to 1 hour default, but the 1 hour is not be enough for the understanding the events in the cluster. So usually separated etcd is deployed to handle loads of events. As I mentioned earlier, there's a lot of events, and some of them is very interesting, and they send very infrequently, so we can miss them. For example, you can see that the NLT or pulled image node started, pod scaled, these are came often, but network is not ready, leader election, scale down failed, such kind of events may be sent less frequently so that we can miss them, but they are causes, they will be cause important outages maybe. These are the events from Kubernetes source code. Maybe some of you see them, maybe not see them, but they are 12. Our not so busy 10 node cluster publish 2000 events in an hour, and our most busy developer cluster publish 700,000 NR, event NR. So it is not possible for us to see them in the console. And in our case, it is 70 unique reason. As you can see here, the per involved object, the most of them is related to port and replica set on deployments. But this is the normal running stable cluster. But there are also, we can see the distribution of per reason, distribution of events per reason. You can see there is a successful create event is the most published one, but it is also is the stable cluster. If your cluster is not stable, you can see the unhealthy events published or backoff events published mostly, or you can see the sandbox changed events, and these are can be missed. We have to analyze them. We have to create alert from them. In order to do this, we create an open source project for alerting. Mustafa can start.
Hello, everyone. I will be talking about a little about proper mounting and alerting. So I will mainly focus on what should be an alert or a notification or an insight. Alerts should be designed for human consumption. They should be structured, precise, actionable, and noise-free so that the on-call person, whoever it is, can see the related information and act on them. So they should be carefully designed. For example, this event, backoff restarting failed container. If your container is failing the health checks, it will be or readiness probes, it will be in restart loop, but you have to include the involved object's name so that it should be useful, and the namespace can be a differentiator. For example, kube system namespace should be more monitored than developer namespaces, and we also made a tool to get the labels of the involved object so that you can customize your routing logic or any logic you want with those labels. We can also, aside from the alerts, extract information and metrics for gaining extra observability. As I said, alerts should be usually warnings and some information, but the monitoring should be monitoring can be done with alerting and filtering and aggregation over a time series can give you really good information. For example, these images are from our New Relic Insights where we push those events. You can see how many different images are pulled throughout the day. These are the unique image counts. So if there's a spike, you can see that someone misconfigured and it always pulls the images, different images. We can see from the failed scheduling event, there is capacity issues or any other issue that there is a spike in that hour. It's probably when the developers start working on our cluster. And there are, the autoscaler cannot keep up. And you can see if they are actually related to capacity errors by digging down from the events, because if there's no capacity, the event message contains insufficient capacity. And we can see how many objects are created or updated throughout the day so that you can see the patterns if there are any correlations. And we can see, are there any amount of significant warning events? Are they increasing or are they really minimal? And we can also see the event counts per distribution. Normally the events are deduplicated. They are not published again and again. Only the count is increased. And you see that some events are have very large counts of deduplication and they can be telling a story. And the most CRDs, the operators, controllers, the people contribute are publishing events for their observability. For example, we use Kinesis build for our one of our developer cluster, and it publishes events. And cluster autoscaler might be publishing some events. It publishes events when it's scaling down or scaling up, and you can visualize them. Also, we use Cert Manager for developer certificates, and you can see that is there any error doing that. I will also talk about our event exporter tool. We made the tool with event routing and filtering. Events are received from a single watcher, and they are it has a configuration language I will show you later that is inspired a little bit from Alert Manager from Prometheus. It allows filtering out or routing based on the tags, labels, messages. And it also has multiple outputs so that you don't have to run multiple tools for this because you can create one alert, an alert from an event or send all of them to the Elasticsearch or Supplank. And we also have payload customization so that you can create custom JSON schema, not just the event data. Because we have some internal tools that are accepting only in a certain format. For reporting, it's when you just want to export data, so it's logical to put them to Elasticsearch, Kafka, or PubSub. For alerting, we obviously created Opsgenie integration, and it's for the eyes of the on-call. And for notification, you might need to notify an owner of the pod from Slack. Or you can create a webhook that you want to do anything you want. When you create an alert from an event in Opsgenie, it looks like this. You can put the JSON data of the alert, put the tags. So the one team's event is routed to that team, or you can set priorities. For the implementation, we create the generic watcher tool. It's pretty easy to do. But it requires some care because at first you receive all the events and you need to resource you need to care for resource consumption. And we made a generic client that can take the labels of any object because normally the client Go is typed. We had to use a generic version of that. And we have to do some output buffering and usage of Go routines so that the multiple outputs do not block each other and work efficiently. For configuration, we have routing and we have matches and drops so that you can just dump all the events with the top watcher, and this route can be recursive route configuration. So you can drill down and send it to the related parties. For example, you can create alerts from the failed events, but you can just send them, drop the test namespaces, test named namespaces, and the normal events. For outputs, we also have we also support multiple outputs in that in this tool. You can get you can use the fields in the alert for constructing select messages or Opsgenie alerts, or you can just push them to the Ops Elasticsearch as a whole. We also have the payload customization. This is we use AWS Kinesis for our application metrics, and it's it gets the events in a specified format with these four fields, so it can also do that. So we avoid writing more codes, and you can easily create integrations without writing code. So I will, before closing up, I want to talk about where did this project come from. We attended the KubeCon Barcelona, and we loved everyone sharing their experiences and their tooling in an open and welcoming environment. As Ahmet said, we have many monitoring tools due to the nature of our work we do in Opsgenie. And we see that with a little bit generalization, we could open source some of them. And this is something new to us. We love open sourcing stuff, and we will be open sourcing some more projects in the future. And thank you all for listening. If you have any questions or comments, you're welcome to continue. Is there a mic? He's bringing. You are also welcome to join our booth if you want to ask any more questions. He's asking.
So for your the collector, does it run as a containerized pod in Kubernetes itself?
Yes. Or so, you can run it from the outside if you want.
So is there a possibility of a feedback loop from the operation of the container creating events that would cause the thing to keep cycling and get more events?
No, there is no... as I understand from your question, our pod would also publish events, and they will publish events. Our pod doesn't publish custom events, so that there's no recursion loop.
Hi, thanks for the talk. This looks really great. I might have missed it, but do you guys support exporting all the metrics to Prometheus? It seems like there's going to be a lot of people that are going to want to just track the metrics for alerting rather than individual alerts.
Sure. Prometheus requires a strict definition of the metrics, so we did not have Prometheus implementation. We are not sure how to implement it, because it's usually, how I say, it's usually about the values of the metrics. The only value here is the counts. So maybe we can make some regular expressions. If this regular expressions is matched, increase the count or make a histogram for that, we will gladly implement it. Does anyone have any question?
I don't have a question. I just want to say this is awesome.
Yeah, thanks.